Today we have another TV that's come onto the Australian market with scart sockets in the back. This is a JVC branded TV. It's the first JVC I've had. They rarely come with scart, so I've seen this one and one much older that belongs to a friend that's scart, so it's pretty rare for JVC to do that. The model number is the AV32X25EU. This is the manual. The manual's like, it's massive, but that's due to all the different languages that it's got. You'll actually see here that this number represents the model closest to the TV's model number on the back. The TV's model number actually has an S after that, so there's a little bit of discrepancy there going on. Here's the remote, proper JVC remote, and has a slide down panel for VCR and DVD controlling. I haven't already mentioned it, it's 32 inches in size, widescreen, pure flat. There's its signification of being 100Hz digital pro. It's not what we want, but that's how it is. Very strangely, there is actually a panel here at the front that can be pulled out, but does not reveal anything in particular. There's no buttons or anything. It looks like a bay, an expansion bay perhaps. I'm thinking that a different model of this TV or a different chassis that goes into this shell may have connections that would normally be here, but that's very unusual. I've never seen any sort of vacant bay in a TV like that before. We'll try and have a bit more of a look at that when we go inside. I'll take you around the back. It's a fairly wide TV, like it's 32 inches in size, but it's got fairly big sides for speakers. Fairly curvy around the back. Okay, where's it made? There's the model number again. Manufactured in the United Kingdom. And you can tell with the model number there, it's got EU for European Union, so it's definitely a European model that Australia's just happened to get this time around. Down here, we've got the triple scart and the audio out, antenna in, and power. Oh, that's interesting. We've actually got a position here to plug in a UK power plug, not an Aussie one, but that's for the UK power plug, and you can wrap your cord around there a bit, I suppose. Take up some of the slack. Hey, I've never seen a TV with a socket in the back. That's quite nice. Too bad it's not for this market though. Righto, I'll whip the back off and see what's in it. I'm sort of tipping there'll be a Phillips tube inside, but we'll see. Oh, and one other thing too is there's a set of inputs there at the back, just near the front of the TV there. S video composite, channel up, down, volume up, down. There's one more. With the back off now, I'm somewhat half right about the tube, I suppose you could say. It is a Phillips, but it's at the time when LG and Phillips were working together. Made in Germany, so that's nice. Not surprising with the TV made in the UK that the tube is a Phillips. Made in Germany as well. I've seen a lot of the LG, or Phillips I should say, tubes that are made in Germany. I could actually just kind of tell by the picture that it was going to be one of these. So there's our chassis, a bit dusty inside. Nothing else to really make note of. You got your speaker over there and one over there. No big woofer enclosure anywhere. No additional speakers down the front. As far as that cavity down the front's concerned, I mean, that's not really revealing anything. But yeah, you can see some mounting holes there at the front, some screw holes, so it's probably is capable of seating another chassis inside this unit to take advantage of that vacant area in the front. I don't think it's venting at all. I mean, it's covered up with that panel, so it's not going to be some sort of airflow thing. Righto, let's fire it up. Okay, the TV's turned on. We'll have a look at the menu system. It's a fairly nice looking menu system. Go to external settings. I should point out that scart 1 and 2, which in this case EXT1 is scart 1, EX2 is scart 2, and EXT3 is scart 3. Number 1 is for RGB, number 2 is also for RGB. Number 2 can be designated as S video.
there. I can designate it, the ECS video come up, or I can turn it off and that'll be back in RGB. SCART 3 is not RGB, it's only composite, but can be also designated as S video, as you can see there. Main thing is we do have RGB on SCART 1 and SCART 2. To get into the service menu, all you need to do is hold the sound mute button at the top there and the information button here. Push those two at the same time and you're into the service menu. That's the easiest method I've seen to get into any service menu on any television. It's actually quite nice, very simple and straightforward. There is also another deeper menu that you can access here from the main menu. Again, sound mute and info at the same time. And there you go, gets you into the deeper menu. You can see that this is really a UK model, this television, because destination is set as European Union. There's no Australian option in there. For most users, the interesting thing will be option 4, I think it is, where it has things like vertical shift, vertical size, horizontal centering, horizontal size, and etc. etc. So there's lots of adjustments there that you can use. Very easy to get out, just like that. You're out of service menu. And picture features. It has a tilt option that all these modern CRTs do. I think it's pretty much right where it is. And the only other things I want to report here in them is picture features. Is really this nonsense here, this digital VNR and DigiPure Pro. You know, all these 100 hertz televisions have these so-called enhancements and modes to improve things, but again, the best thing is just to turn them all off. If you have them turned up to max, you basically get more smearing with your picture, so just turn them right off. But we are talking 100 hertz here, and I'm not going to give you any surprises, eh? It's just another 100Hz television in the end, but we'll actually do a bit of gaming now and see how it looks. Okay, so let's just pretend that I'm watching television. This is an analog set, so it's got no antenna hooked up to it right now. No, it doesn't receive digital transmission, but pretending that we are watching TV here, the TV is wired so that once it receives signal from one of its SCART sockets, and in this case the Saturn is plugged in to one of the SCART sockets, it will automatically switch to the input. And as you can see, the Saturn is coming up. Some TVs do it, some don't. Some auto switch, some don't. Just the way it is. Fortunately, you can also change from widescreen into 4:3. Here is a menu for those things. Go to regular. And there you go, we're in 4:3. I like that. Sometimes you don't get that choice. Alright, I've got to put a game on there. Okay, so with this game on, all scan lines are gone. This is the Sega Saturn here. Not unusual for any 100Hz television to do that, to remove all scan lines. If I go into the menu here, what you will want to avoid are the presets here of cool, the cool colour. Cool picture preset looks terrible. If I can just get back into it, actually has color turned to maximum. Ken's like a really bright orange. That's just the TV's default in the cool setting. You can also go to warm, but warm has its sharpness, as you can see. I highlight it there. It's turned to maximum. Looks horrid as well. Just go to normal and then fine tune it yourself from there. Probably turn the colour down a little bit and maybe fiddle with the contrast. Alright, let's just see what else this TV is going to do. I'm putting an interlace source into the JVC. I wanted to show you here these stripes, these vertical stripes over here, the purple in particular. I don't know how the camera's going to pick that up, but with these stripes, they're just a sequence of colours that, just a sequence of columns of colours, but there's a purple strip in there that's just, it looks ugly. It's not discrete, it's like, it's just jittering and moving around. It's just a side effect of the TV's digital processing that's come apparent on that screen, so, yeah, it's not handling it well. I'm going to test a gun game now. I don't normally, because I know it's not going to work, but I think I'll do that from now on in videos, just in case by some chance a miracle does occur. Righto, so the game I've got here, oddly enough, is called Henry Explorers. It's a very strange name. It's the Japanese version of Crypt Killer. It's a gun game. It's for the Saturn. Also came out on PlayStation and arcade. I'll start it. Well, I think you've got an idea already that it's not going to work. Come on.
Do not be surprised. I am Yamazan.
Look left.
No good. 100 hertz refresh rate, preventing me from using this gun correctly. The gun will not work on the TV. No go. One last test for the TV. Sometimes the TV doesn't like when more than two devices are plugged in and turned on at the same time. So I've got the Saturn in one SCART socket now, which is working fine. And I also have a PlayStation 2 in the other SCART socket that is also working fine. So it passes in that regard. Just getting through to the PS2. Here we go, that's in RGB there, and the PS2 looking very bright. So that's pretty much it. It's just what you would expect, a typical 100Hz television. If you've seen numerous reviews I've done on other things, other 100Hz TVs like this, this would be no different. It's not really any better than any others. It doesn't look as good as a classic CRT that has a refresh rate of 50 or 60 hertz. It doesn't have any component input or VGA input. You know, there's nothing really there to recommend it, but it's another one crossed off the list for the hunt or the search for SCART TVs in Australia, but you know, the JVC hasn't provided the goods, so that's pretty much it. Yeah, don't go looking for it. There's no need for it, so thanks for watching, and I'll keep looking for more SCART TVs. Bye.